In this video, I'll uncover the best hours for intermittent fasting. Hi, ladies and gentlemen, I'm Dr. Zarowski, and welcome back to the channel. If you're new to the channel, it's a pleasure to have you here. Be sure to subscribe, hit that bell notification, and join our notification community so I can help you excel your health and your life. In this video, we're talking about the best hours for intermittent fasting. You know, this is a powerful video because I get a lot of questions, people asking, should I be doing 16 and 8 intermittent fasting? Should I cut the hours down from 16 hours? Maybe can I get away with a 12-hour fast? Some people are asking, should I be really doing one meal a day so I get maximum benefit? So what I want to do is actually look to the research and find out what is happening at a physiological level from hour 0 all the way to hour 24 when fasting. And so what I've done is turn to the research. We're going to review a graph and look at all these different physiological markers and once again start at 0 to 24 hours of fasting and really see how all these changes are occurring and what hours they're occurring. So let's go ahead and start with blood glucose. Now when we look at blood glucose here, it's represented on this graph with this green line. Now the green line, essentially you ate a meal, then over time the blood glucose drops within the first hour or so, and then it plateaus at a pretty high point right here. But then once we hit the 13 to 14 hour mark, the blood glucose drops down to a new low, and then it rebounds back. But when it rebounds back and it plateaus, it really has a much lesser level of glucose within the body, and it rides out until the rest to the fast is over at that 24 hour point, let's say if you're just going to 24 hours. And so anyway, we see that fasting helps bring blood sugar to a new low in the body, which is very powerful for overall health. Now, when we look at glycogen, glycogen is represented by this black line. Essentially, what glycogen is stored sugar in the body, stored sugar in the liver, stored sugar in the muscle tissue. Now, glycogen drops over that time, and once we hit about the 12-hour mark, glycogen just kind of bottoms out, and it rides that out. And so the reason for that is because our body is using all that stored sugar during that time. Next here, next hormone we're going to look at is plasma glucagon. Now, glucagon is represented by this blue line. Now, glucagon essentially is going to counteract the effects of insulin on the body. And so when we're fasting, what happens is the pancreas releases glucagon, and the glucagon goes and it starts releasing all that stored sugar in the muscle tissues and the liver, which is the glycogen that we just reviewed. And so when we look at glucagon as we fast, it continues to go up and it continues to tell the body, hey, keep releasing all that sugar in the body because we need it for energy. And then eventually, that's why we see that glycogen level just bottom out, because glucagon has just told it all to release and is now used up. Next here is going to be insulin. Now we know how important insulin is. Insulin is represented by this yellow dotted line right here. Essentially what we see is when fasting, it drops down, but once we hit that 13 to 14 hour mark, it hits a low and then it rebounds slightly, but then it rides out at a new low level. This is so powerful for overall health because we know that if we keep that insulin level low, we can keep inflammation low in the body, we can keep the fat storage in the body low, and it offers really powerful health benefits. So by fasting and doing intermittent fasting on a daily basis, you're essentially gonna find that your insulin level stays much lower than those who don't. Next here on our list is gonna be free fatty acids. Now, free fatty acids represented by this black line right here. Now, free fatty acids, essentially what that means is that when we're fasting, what happens is we start burning the fat on our body for energy. And so what happens is lipolysis occurs. As lipolysis occurs, starts breaking down that fat around your waist, the fat on your arms, the visceral fat. Essentially what happens is releases all those free fatty acids into the body so that they can be used for energy. What we find is right at the 12-hour mark, the free fatty acids just skyrocket. Right at the 13-14 hour mark, they peak and then slowly drop back down. What we see follow suit there though is the blood ketones. Once those free fatty acids really take off, the blood ketones skyrocket up and they continue to rise throughout that fast. Now here's the thing that makes this so powerful is that we know that at the 12-hour mark is where most of this starts. Between 12 and 16 hours, essentially what's happening is you just really change from a sugar-burning individual to a fat-burning individual. And essentially, that means that you're burning that fat on your body for energy. And so between the 12 and 16-hour mark, we have massive physiological changes that are occurring. Once we hit that 16-hour mark, most of them have kind of just steadied out. And so the good news is that if you really want to get the benefits of fasting, you have to at least be hitting those 16 hours. But the good news is is that the 16 hours is very powerful. So some people look at one meal a day and they think that that might be the only way to get real benefits of fasting, but the 16 and 8 is super powerful. Now, if you're someone who is trying to get away with like 12 or 14, not nearly as powerful, because we can see that a lot of these changes or these physiological changes are occurring during that time, but they haven't really met their peak state to where they're going to offer you the best benefit. And so when we look at the best hours for intermittent fasting, 16 and 8 is really powerful, simply because it's, for one, it's very sustainable and it's very easy for people to get into. Now, if you want to really maximize your benefits, you can do one meal a day, because essentially what's going to happen is you're going to be able to ride out all these amazing changes that happen in the body over that 16-hour period. You're going to be able to ride that out for another 6 to 7 hours, and that is powerful as well. So when we look at this, this is really what's happening at a physiological level when we are doing intermittent fasting or one meal a day. Be sure to give this video a thumbs up, share it with your friends, subscribe to my channel, and if you have any questions, put it in the comment section here below. Other than that, check out the other videos that I've done on how you can improve your health. I'll see you in the next video.